Assalamu alaikum friends, welcome to this MATLAB tutorial. Today I am going to teach you how to design closed loop boost converter using adaptive neuro fuzzy inference system in MATLAB Simulink software. Friends, to apply ANFIS controller on boost converter, I am considering this closed loop boost converter Simulink model as shown here. On this topic, I have already made the video, namely how to design closed loop boost converter using PID controller in Simulink. Furthermore, to fully understand this closed loop boost converter, you need to first understand the open loop boost converter. On this topic, I have already made the video, namely how to design boost converter in MATLAB Simulink software. Therefore, if you can watch these both videos and apply this ANFIS controller in this model and compare its response with PI controller based model, then this model can be used for your master degree research or one of the PhD research objectives. Now just look at the model. It may be observed that in this model we are using the PI controller. Double click on this PI controller block. You can see the parameters of the PI controllers are 0.7 and 100 for P and I respectively. Let's check the voltage graph using this PI controller at these values. Run the simulation by clicking on this play button. Double click on this scope to see the output voltage response. It may be noted that we need the output voltage of 20 volt. The scope shows that the output voltage has the mean value of 19.83 volt, which is close to 20 volt, but contains ripples in it. Moreover, it has very high overshoot at the start, ranging to almost 29.68 volt. Similarly, double click on this scope to see the current response. It may be noted that we need the inductor current of 8.3 ampere as shown here, whereas this scope shows the inductor current has the mean value of 8.868 ampere, which is slightly higher than the 8.3 ampere value and contains ripples in it. Furthermore, it has very high overshoot at the start, ranging to almost 47.07 ampere. This response can be further improved by replacing this PI controller with ANFIS controller. Friends, in order to compare the response of this model with PI controller and with ANFIS controller, first copy the whole model and paste it here. As we know that ANFIS controller needs the input and output data of the system for its successful training. Therefore, to get the combined input and output data, we need multiplexer block. For this purpose, go to Simulink library and bring this multiplexer block from here to the model. Bring this block here. Connect one port with the input of the PI controller and the other port with the output of the PI controller. Now go to Simulink library again, then go to sync. You can see here two workspace block is available. Take this block and bring it in the model. Connect this block here. Double click on this block. In the variable name, write data, because this is the combined input and output data. In the save format, click on choose array and press OK. Now run the simulation in order to shift this input and output data from the Simulink model to workspace. Come to command window. You can see in the workspace section we have data variable available. Double click on this data variable to see its values. You can see it shows two columns. First column shows input data, whereas second column shows the output data. It may be noticed that we want to get the output value, which can give us the value close to 20 volt. For this purpose, come to model again. You can notice that the output of PI controller shown here is around 0.42 something. At this output value, the output voltage is close to or slightly higher than 20 volt. Therefore, we also have to change the output values in such a way to get the output voltage close to 20 volt. Now again, look at the output values in the data. You can see its initial values are 0.7, which has resulted in very high values of above 30 volt as shown in the voltage graph. As we want to reduce this peak value, therefore we will try to change this output data in such a way to get the lesser peak. Therefore, in the first values, try to put the value as 0.1 up to 20,000 samples. Then put the value as 0.4456 in the rest samples. Now our data is prepared. Therefore, let's start to design adaptive neuro fuzzy inference system based controller. Come to command window, type ANFIS edit and press enter. A new window will open showing the ANFIS controller GUI toolbox. At the first stage, we have to upload the data for the training. The training data may be uploaded from the file if already saved by you in any folder, or it may also be uploaded from the workspace section. As our data is available in the workspace, therefore select here workspace. Then click on load data. Now write here data and press OK. You can see the data is successfully uploaded. Look at the window again. The vertical axis shows the minimum and maximum range of the output variables, whereas the horizontal axis shows the total number of samples. Now come to generate fuzz section. It has many options available. The first option asks you to upload the fuzzy file from a file if you have already saved it. The second option asks you to upload the fuzzy file from the workspace if you have the file in the workspace. Third option is based on the grid partition. It means that this will create fuzzy logic controller by itself. The fourth option is based on the subtractive clustering. It means that this will also create fuzzy logic controller by itself. However, subtractive clustering can only be used if we have more than one inputs in our data. As our data has only one input, therefore we cannot use this option. Due to this, we are going to use grid partition option. Now click on generate fuzz. It asks about the number of membership functions as well as the type of membership functions for the input variable. You may choose any number and type of the membership functions. I am using the default settings. The output has again two options. You may choose any of the options based upon your choice. I choose constant in this case and press OK. You can see new fuzzy inference system is generated as shown here. It means that ANFIS has generated the fuzzy file by itself based upon your instructions. Now come to the third section, which is based on training the fuzz consisting of various options. The first option asks you about the optimization method. It has two methods, namely backpropagation and hybrid method. The hybrid method is the combination of backpropagation and least mean squared error method. Therefore, hybrid method mostly provides the best result. I choose hybrid method in this case. The second option is based on error tolerance. Keep the error tolerance to zero. It means we want zero error resulting in 100% accuracy. The third option is based on number of epochs, which simply means number of iterations. You may choose any number of iterations depending upon your choice. I choose here 100. Click on train now to start the training. You can see it has started. At the end of 100 iterations, the minimum error is obtained as shown here. Friends, I think this is okay and almost equal to zero. Now let me show you the further information of the ANFIS controller. Look at this section, it shows that we have used one input and one output with three membership functions in the input variable. Now let me show you the structure of the ANFIS. To see this, click on this structure block. This window shows the ANFIS structure representing the number of inputs, its membership functions, rules, and output. As we have taken three membership functions, therefore three membership functions are shown here. Friends, at this stage, ANFIS training is successfully completed. Now we have to save it. First, we have to export it to workspace so that we can use it in our model. Otherwise, it will give error. To export it, go to File, click on Export, then click on Workspace. A new window will open and ask for the name. Write any name of your choice. I choose Boost ANFIS as the name and press OK. Furthermore, save it in any folder for your reference so that whenever you need, you can use it. To save it, again go to File, click on Export, then click on To File and save it where you want. Look at the workspace window. You can see Boost ANFIS file is available here. Now go to Simulink library and search for the fuzzy logic controller block. Take this block and bring it in the model. Friends, it may be noted that ANFIS also uses the same fuzzy logic controller block. It is because ANFIS is basically making the fuzzy logic controller expert. That's why it is also saved in FIS format. Remove this PI controller block and connect this fuzzy logic controller block here. Double click on this fuzzy logic controller block and write the name of ANFIS file which we have designed now. Therefore, write Boost ANFIS here and press OK. At this stage, our model is completed. Now we can run the simulation to check the performance of the ANFIS controller by clicking on this play button. Double click on this scope to see the output voltage. You can see ANFIS controller has successfully provided the output voltage of 20 volt. Furthermore, it has peak of 24.49 volt. Now compare this response with PI controller based response. You can see PI controller has the output voltage of 19.91 volt, whereas PI controller has peak voltage of 29.68 volt, which is very high compared to ANFIS based controller response. Friends, in this video, I have discussed how to design closed loop boost converter using adaptive neuro fuzzy inference system as an intelligent controller in the MATLAB Simulink software. This model can be used to complete your master degree research or PhD research objectives. For your convenience, I have uploaded this ANFIS based boost converter model in the form of link in the description section of this video. For this purpose, go to the description section of this video. You can see the link is available here. You need to copy this link from the description, paste it in the Google and press enter, or simply click on this link. This new window will be opened, which contains the ANFIS based boost converter model. Now click on this button to download this folder. Click on start download. You can see it has downloaded the folder. Now click on open folder to see the location of this folder. Right click on it and click on cut and bring it in any drive or folder where you want to place it, or create new folder, give it any name of your choice and paste it here. Now right click on this folder and click on extract. You can see it has extracted the folder. Double click on this folder to open it. You can see it contains the PDF file, Simulink model, ANFIS model of the boost converter. Now to open it in MATLAB software correctly, go to MATLAB software screen. Go to D drive or where you have saved this folder in order to bring this folder in the MATLAB as shown here. You can see Simulink model of the ANFIS boost converter is available here. Double click on this model to open it in Simulink. Wait for few seconds. You can see Simulink has opened this model correctly. Similarly, double click on this boost and fizz to load it in workspace section. You can see now it is available in the workspace section. Now you can run the simulation as discussed in this video. You can see it is working fine. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel, and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.